guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. In this tutorial, you will learn about the V-Ray lens effect, which simulates real-world camera effects such as bloom and glare using the new V-Ray frame buffer. If you are using the previous versions of V-Ray like V-Ray Next or V-Ray 3, V-Ray 5 is a lot better than those versions. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Open the V-Ray frame buffer window or click on rendering. This is my current render. My scene setup is extremely simple. I have applied a V-Ray light material on this object and I am lighting these bulbs through it. Save the result. For the lens effect to work, go to Layers panel, click on Lens Effect layer and check Enable Bloom Glare Effect. You can immediately see the effect. No lens effects, lens effects. Now, intensity. Simply increase or decrease the brightness of bloom glare effect. If you drag this value, it will stop at a value of 10. But you can increase it to a maximum of 100 by typing it manually, like 30, 50, 70, 90, or even 100. But you cannot go more than this. Now, Size simply defines the size of the bloom and glare effect. Next, bloom parameter. This is important. Bloom controls the blend between the bloom and glare effect. A value of 1 means full bloom effect. You can see here. Let me just decrease my size a little bit because it is too much. Let's decrease it to 30. You can see when the bloom value is 1, it is totally acting like a bloom effect, soft and blurry. While a value of 0 means fully glare effect. You can see when the bloom is 0, it is totally glare effect. There is no bloom in it. Values in between 0 and 1 blend the two effects proportionally. If I keep it till 0.5, it is a combination of half bloom and half glare effect. Let me just change it to 0.6, a little bit more bloom, towards bloom. Now, if you look closely, let me zoom it. V-Ray lens effect is making bloom and glare effect at these places too, which is definitely we don't want. To solve this, we will use the threshold parameter. Threshold. Its value tells V-Ray which pixel to consider as lens effect source. What do I mean by this? Example. Currently, every pixel in this render whose value is greater than 1 or 1 is considered as a light source. This is the reason that V-Ray is currently giving glare and bloom effect at these places. But if you don't want bloom and glare effect at these places, which is definitely we don't want, so we have to increase the threshold value. Let's increase it from 1 to 3. You can see, as I increase my threshold, all the pixels that have a value of less than 3 have been ignored by the lens effects, and there is now no bloom or glare effect here. Just for a safe side, I'm increasing it to 4, so that little bit of glare that I was having at these places is gone too. But still, if you look closely, there is some glare left at this place. So again, I have to increase my threshold value. because this pixel value is more than 4. So increase it from 4 to 7. Still it is there. Increase it to 10. Still here. Increase it to 12. Now it's all gone. Increase it to, decrease it to 11. It is coming back. Increase it to 12. So 12 is the value where we don't see any lens effects. Now again see it. 1. You are getting these kind of unwanted glares and bloom effect. If you increase it to 12, there is no more bloom or glare effect. As far as the intensity is concerned, it is too much. I'm also going to decrease it. Let's say decrease it to 15. Rotation. Simply rotate the final result effect. Let's increase it to, rotate it to 30 degree. You can see the rotations is happening here. 30, 45, 60, it's up to you, 0. Next parameter, cold and warm. When checked, bloom glare will give cold hues. You can see here, check, unchecked. Again, check it. You can make cold hues more strong by increasing the saturation to its max value, that is 2. If you don't want cold hues and you want warm hues, so simply uncheck this parameter. It will give you warm hues. Warm hues, cold hues. Uncheck it again. Plus, I don't want that much warm, so I will again decrease this saturation to 1. Next, as far as the aperture, lens scratches and dust effect options are concerned, they mainly affect the glare effect and has no effect on the bloom. Just for learning purpose, make the bloom 0, so that we only have the glare. Open the aperture shape. Sights. You can increase or decrease your sights numbers. You can see, if I'm going to increase them, we are making more and more of them. Let's again change it back to its original 6. Rotation, you can simply rotate them. Again, it's up to you. They are very simple. You can easily do them. It's not a big deal. As far as streak blur is concerned, watch here. The more I am going to increase this value, like from 0.2 to 0.5, you will see these corners will turn, become curvy. Plus, you can see these options. It will become more blur. 0.5, 0.75. You can see they are becoming more and more blur. If I make it 1, it will completely blur like a bloom effect. So we didn't need to make it too much blur. A value of okay. Rest of these values are self-explanatory. You simply need to check them and you will see the result instantly. But one thing that I like to do is my lens dust. I normally check lens dust and open its options. I don't want this option to be too intense. So I decrease its density from 50 to 5. And it just gives me a subtle effect like this. See, without lens dust, with lens dust. Now, again, change your bloom to 0.6. And you can see, I have my size around 30, intensity 15, threshold according to your need. I just like a little bit more towards the bloom, so I keep it to 0.6. Turn on the lens dust little bit, like 5, and that's all. Just play with it and you will find it to be extremely easy. I hope you like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating, guys. Bye bye.